Kombuis word met trots geborg deur Be Well. Be Well. Love. Food. Life.
En vandag het ons 'n gaschef in die kombuis. Dit is baie lekker om vir chef Woezie Ndlovu te verwelkom by die groot ontbyt. En hy is vroeër hierdie jaar aangekondig as een van die top 7 chefs in die wêreld, 'n jong opkomende ster. En ons gaan 'n bietjie milies gooi vandag, né? Nee, welkom by die groot ontbyt.
Thank chef. You, thank you.
En dis lekker om jou hier te hê. So, what is happening there?
So, I wanted to show a dish today. That's very simple. It looks very simple. So, this is a sweet corn that we've cooked in grass. So we take
in grass.
Yeah, yeah.
What kind of grass?
Hay.
Okay. Hay.
Yeah. Hay.
Hay.
How are you? So this dish is like very clever in the sense that if you cook grass and butter, it tastes like Horlicks. Yeah. So corn is Horlicks. So that's how it came together. And everyone in the restaurant goes crazy for it. Like, why did you cook it? It's like 50 rand here, so it's like overcharged, but it's beautiful.
Wow.
So I hope you get that idea of it. So basically, that's how I make food at Marabi. Like, we try to do stuff that's very. It looks simple, but it takes us 2 days to make this thing.
Really?
So it's like, yo, it's just a milli, what's wrong with you? It's the best milli.
Okay, but when you cook it in the hay, is it like a smoking process?
No. So it's like more of like a baking process, more like a steaming and baking process. So we put like 1 kilo of butter and like 2 kilos of hay. And then, you let it bake in there till it's like beautifully done.
And it steams.
Yeah,
it
steams
in a
and
pot.
Bakes, so the butter gets the flavor and then it's perfect.
2 kilos of butter, you say.
Okay,
and what kind of canola be well
So I'm just going to finish it off with this lemon flavored canola, just for some acidity, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Must get some for my house. Just a touch.
And I see you you pour it over the milli the whole time.
Yeah, so I think just to make it soak in the butter.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Everything's better with butter.
Tell us about Marabi. You're the head chef there. It's a very interesting jazz club vibe restaurant in Johannesburg.
It's very it's like a little hidden gem, you know, it's like downtown in the corner somewhere.
Yeah.
No one knows what it is. Or you come in and it's like, oh, beautiful furniture. Some crazy guys dancing and cooking, like what's going on here? But I mean, it's a beautiful place to be.
Yeah.
Beautiful music, beautiful food, beautiful architecture. I mean,
and how old are you?
I'm 27 now.
27, you're the head chef there.
Getting old now, so I'll be
30
soon.
No, believe me, you're not old.
thank you.
And how do you serve that, just as it is?
I'm not sure, you know, it's very easy. People must use their hands to eat it.
Yeah, so
we'll plate that up real quickly.
Yeah.
It's just, mustn't cut myself. I try to serve it like this, but no one likes it like that.
Yeah.
So it's very.
Oh, so it's actually soft in the inside because it has cooked for two days in hay and butter.
Exactly. So you just need to put some muscle.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, so it's easy to chow.
It's cute.
That's very cute. Okay, fantastic. Now we're going to. Chop this up further, and when
then,
we come
back,
we're going to have an interesting interview with Woezie, so stay tuned.
Excited.
En ons milies wat 2 dae gevat het om gaar te word, glo vir my, want dit is in hooi en 2 kg botter gekook, soos wat chef Woezie vir ons gesê het, is nou gereed en dit is van die lekkerste milies wat ek nog in my lewe geproe het, ek moet sê. Chef Woezie, so first of all tell us, it's amazing that you are top 7 best young chef. That's a world-renowned title that you got earlier this year in Milan,
stressful,
in Italy.
Stressful.
And you got it with the dish that you call isiqupo.
Yeah.
And I heard you based it on your childhood memories.
Exactly.
What does it comprise of?
So when we were young, we used to play a game where you like hunt for birds with like a hose pipe and a stone. Then you trap it. So isiqupo means trap. So once you catch that dish, the uncles would cook it and everyone would just like eat it. So that's like nothing special, you know, no aging. So that's what I took that moment and sort of, and in our culture, pumpkin is like a big thing. It's like grows everywhere, all year round. I mean, everyone does it.
Yeah.
So I took pumpkin and duck and I did a grain porridge with like barley and pumpkin seeds. Because every time we played on the farm, you'd eat porridge. So I was like, okay, porridge and duck and pumpkin. So yeah, it's got like a crazy, crazy components. The duck was aged for 5 weeks. In grass. I like grass.
You like cooking in grass?
No, just for now. It's a phase. And then it had a fermented pumpkin with mkomboti, which we made ourselves. But it made it very strong.
Yeah.
So we did that, and then we had some duck biltong actually. So we took the duck legs.
What?
And then you smoke them, or you cure them, then you smoke them like super smoky, and you grate it on top. So it looks, it tastes like it's been cooked on the fire, but it hasn't. So it was a clever dish, I think.
You like pushing the boundaries, eh? Like one of the dishes at the Marabi Jazz Club is calamari paired with grapes and a few other stuff.
Yeah, tell us
about the menu at the
So the menu is not, it's like, there's no rules to it, you know? There's no, okay, we need to have a starch, two vegetables, I don't like that. I grew up in the fine dining world and I thought it was too serious. So now I just like to have fun. Like, I don't know, we made a broccoli dish, broccoli with seaweed and wasabi. Yeah, so that's cool, but it's like the best seller now. I'm like, why are you buying the broccoli? Buy the lamb. So I don't know, we just make stuff that's like really comfortable for us that we can understand. No one else has to understand it, but just try it once and then we take it from there.
And it suits Joburg, you know, of in course. That Maboneng precinct.
Yeah, everyone's cool, everyone dresses funny now, you know, everyone's got like 7 earrings and all, yeah, and purple hair. So I feel as though like, why not just adapt to the place? It's not Santa.
So you've seen your part of weird clients.
I won't call them weird, I like different clients.
Yeah.
But they're interesting, we get everyone at the club, we get like fancy people, we get students from Wits, so there's no, anyone can come. You
know? So, what do you think is the relationship or the important link between music, like the Marabi Jazz Club, and food?
Well, I think no matter where you go in the world, right, there's like, I think there's two things that people can relate to. Like, we don't have to speak the same language, but when it comes to food, we can agree that this is nice or not nice. Or if it's music, you can be like, okay, I don't like that. But so there's common language between it, like without saying too much. Mm. So I feel as though if you have good music while having good food, I think it's a simple philosophy, I think. Mm. But that's what I think.
And maybe a last philosophical question. What do you think, or why do you think, is it so difficult for South African chefs to reach their goal or to make a living out of food? Especially in comparison with chefs elsewhere in the world?
Well, you know what, like I'll say, let's say Paris. So when you go to school in Paris, you start cooking at 14. So you've got so much more experience when you get to 21. But when you're in South Africa, like you need to pay for student loans, you need to, it's expensive, these chef schools. Mm-hmm. That's why I didn't go. So I think, and when you finish college, you want to be like a sous chef already, or you want to, so your mentality is now driven to make money, not to actually cook. So when you start asking for 40,000 rand a month when you're 21, you want to struggle. So I think people need to take their time and just like really be sure they want to do this job, because it's not going to be easy for like the next 10 years.
Yeah,
don't rush it. Money will come if you're good. If you're not good, then I don't know. Mm. I hope that answers the question.
Yeah.
So I think it's going to be, it takes time, but I think it's just patience and wanting to learn actually before wanting to make money. Then.
Yeah.
That's what I can
the
say.
The passion drives you as well.
Oh, you need to wake up in the morning and come go to work at 6 in the morning. So if you don't have the passion or the desire, it won't happen.
And just tell me, with this promising recognition behind you, what lies ahead?
I don't know, hey, like everyone's been asking, but I feel as though for me, Marabi must be top 20 next year in ETAS Awards. So if I can do that, then I can start making other plans, because that'd be it for me. Like.
Okay.
So I think we can do it. The more people we get, the more people get to see our food, and I think we can do it comfortably. Maybe top 30, but I think it's possible. That's my big plan.
Okay, so maybe next year it's top 5. Oh, if it was top 7 this year, it could be top 5 next year.
So I got a personal award, so I have to get an award for the whole team now to make everyone else celebrate the success. Because it's not just about me, you know, like I'm not doing it by myself. Like. We've got a big team at work, like great waiters, great dancers, great bouncers, great bands. So I think for them to have an award that they can say, this is Marabi's award.
Yeah.
That would be more special. Maybe I'll get an increase. We'll see. I hope. I would say that.
I would give you an increase if I was your boss.
Thank you. Did you hear that?
Yeah. Okay. Did you hear that, boss?
Thank
it was
you.
An honor chatting to you, man.
Thank you for
having
me. Thank you.
27 to become top 7 young promising chef in the world. That recognition is really amazing. Yeah. But still, you stay humble, and that's what I appreciate about you.
People think I'm crazy, but I'm the nicest guy in the world. Like,
people also think I'm crazy. I don't know why, man.
I love. It's fine.
But they keep thinking that. Yeah. It was wonderful having you here.
Thank you very much.
We're gonna gooi Millies now, and you can go check out social media for some more pictures and the recipe of this amazing 2-day butter and hay millie. Cheers.
Thank you.